Hello, welcome to my first Minecraft video. I've been playing Minecraft for about 2 months now and I love combining things like this melon farm done by a monkey farm, and I connected it to a piston clock which will automatically harvest the melons every 5 seconds or something. Let's just view this from above. On the left at the melon farm, then a bit to the right is the piston clock, and at the bottom right is a restart of as piston clocks from time to time clock up. And now I'm going to show you how to build this yourself. I'll start by digging a hole that's 6x7. And I'm gonna speed things up a lot. Next, after you're done with the hole, place redstone repeaters on each side, facing inward, 6 on each side, like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can already connect these with redstone. Then take some sticky pistons and put them in the middle. And finally dump dirt on top of it. Now build the water channels, one on each side, as melons will grow better if there's water next to them. Then I'm already leading the redstone out. First of all, place a redstone torch. The signal needs to be inverted. And then put redstone all the way up. Oops, and better close this off. There's going to be a water source on the right, and you don't want it to remove all your redstone in a bit. Put a stone block on each side to prevent the melons from spawning over there, and same on the other side. And this is where the water source is going to be, one of them. Okay, take a hoe and build some farmland. Same thing on the other side. And then plant your melon seeds and use some bone meal to let them grow instantly, like that. Okay, next I'll put 2 water sources in here just to test how it's working. Okay, hey, wow, there's already a melon grown. See, melons don't need farmland to grow on. Recognize what will do, and now if I place the redstone torch, the bottom will retract. Yeah, now next we have to push the melon downwards, so it will slice up into melon slices. Okay, let's lead the redstone over here. And then we have to build another floor, second layer of sticky pistons. Now build three up. Yeah, clean things up a little. Place some torches. Yeah, still looks the same. I'll remove the water sources for now. They will just push me forward all the time for when I try to place these sticky pistons. I'll leave the melon intact to show you how to harvest them. Okay, again, two rows of sticky pistons, six on each side, facing downwards. Yeah, you can remove this for now, and next we have to connect the redstone. And as I'm going to show you next how to harvest that melon, I will disconnect the redstone for now. Okay, the easiest way to do this is place blocks on top of the pistons and then just connect everything with redstone. You could also do it with repeaters on each side, which would be for one level lower. But then again, you would need another 12 repeaters. Now I'm placing a repeater there to make sure for the signal is strong enough. And I forgot to put the water sources back in. And you also need to place some blocks below these sticky pistons. I went for glass blocks, but actually you can do whatever you want. The melon blocks don't mind whatever's above them, whereas above the melon stems you have either to leave a block of air or use glass or glowstone. If you place opaque blocks over the melon stems, they won't grow any melon blocks. Okay, now that we're done, I'll place another redstone torch, and this is how it works. Pistons come down, harvest the melon, melon slices flow towards you. Okay, next, the piston clock. The pistons will be residing on a plot of block of their own, and there are four apart. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, the next piston block. And again, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and another block. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, block. There. And this is what it should look like now. Oh yeah, these may not be sticky pistons. You must use regular pistons, because otherwise the piston clock works by pushing for blocks all the way around, and if you use sticky pistons this wouldn't work, as the blocks would always retract. Now I'm just using wool to connect the pistons, but again you can use whatever you want as long as it's not glass or glowstone. Okay, four on each side. 1, 2, 4. And another 4. And then leave one space open. Like that. Because the pistons will have to start pushing somewhere. And if you use blocks all around, then this wouldn't work. Next, I'm using furnaces to prevent the blocks from being pushed outward, because I want to go them clockwise. Instead of furnaces, you can also use obsidian, but then again, furnaces are easier to get and easier to destroy. Okay. Then I want to lead some redstone out toward the side where the other redstone is. So I'm just placing a little redstone here and a torch. And this wool block is preventing the redstone from passing through. And but we are gonna resolve this in a bit. And next I'm building a bridge, because the piston clock is surrounded by a redstone clock, a complete redstone circuit, and we need to bridge this somehow. And you can already connect this to your melon farm, like that. Yeah, and better put a repeater in just to be on the safe side. Now, this piston clock is working clockwise. You can also build it the other way around, but if you do it clockwise, the redstone circuit has also to be working clockwise. So I'm gonna start at this piston and then work my way around, and always put a redstone repeater between pistons. That's 1 to 4, like that. Connect the next piston. Then repeater, set it to 4. Piston. And the last repeater, set it to 4. And close the circuit. Okay. Now we can already test this. Place a redstone torch. And of course it's stuck. Just restart it by removing a piece of redstone and putting it back again, and now your clock is working. It's not a clock here, it's more like a wall circuit. It's going to become a clock soon. So let's stop this for now. And then glass blocks will let the redstone signal through. I'm just going to replace one block on each side with a glass block. Like that. And same block on the opposing side. Like that. Now let's just restart the piston clock. Just with a short pulse. And this is how it works. Block still being pushed around clockwise, but every now and then a glass block is in right there, and that's the redstone current from the redstone torch in the middle through, like that. Now when the glass block is at the bottom, now the redstone lights up and the melon farm goes off again. Yeah, and this happens like every 5 seconds. And then between there's plenty of time for melon to regrow. And then the piston will just come down again. Now a problem with piston clocks is if you lock out and then lock back in into Minecraft, the clocks often get stuck like that, with everything being lit. You can resolve this by a restarter. Next I'm going to show you how to build one. Now first of all you need a redstone repeater, because there's going to be a block that has to be powered. Just take another sticky piston and put it over there. Regular stone block in front of it and some redstone to the side of it. Repeater there, another repeater, set that to 2 and connect it with redstone. Now if I power this, I'm using redstone torch here, but better use a lever. This will allow you to restart and stop the piston clock and the automatic harvesting. You can just restart the clock and start harvesting. And that's it. Automatically harvesting melons in the sunset. I hope you liked it.